Hello everyone, my name is JMLisondra and today I'm going to teach you how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. So today my subject will be an underwater river. So yeah, I'm going to try to make it it's look like an underwater, everyone. And I'm going to put a fish there. I'm going to put my main subject as a fish. And yeah, that will be my plan today and I hope that you will like it. And please don't forget to subscribe. If you haven't subscribed it, and hit the bell button if you want to receive some future notifications of my new videos and tutorials. You can see all the materials needed on the screen. You can see the 5 different colors, the brushes that we're gonna need, and all the things that we're gonna need to paint this painting. Okay, so I'm going to start now. And I'm gonna try to put some colors because I'm gonna use a palette knife. Okay, so I'm gonna put some blue here. Yeah, I'm using big colors, everyone. Then I'm gonna try to also to put some white. There, I'm gonna mix the two colors, everyone. Then some yellow also. There. So I have now some initial colors on my palette. On my canvas. I have also colors on my palette here. Okay, so let's try to mix using this palette knife. There. So I'm gonna create something like a wave here, like that. There, I can make it a little bit higher. What I like about using a palette knife, everyone, is I can use a thicker, and the paints will be thicker and also solid. Okay, so let's use the small 1.5 inch flat brush. 1.5 inch flat brush. Okay, so let's try to blend this color here like that. Actually, my studio now, everyone, is very, very hot. Let's try to blend it a bit here, and let's try to put some throw umber on this part here. Throw umber and the blue. Okay. Put some blue here. I like the foundation of the background around, so come. So just put some raw umber. Yeah. I want it to be dark, everyone. There. Okay. Clean your brush, just clean your brush, everyone, and you can blend more here. There. And then you can use a bit of white and the blue or some skies at the top. Okay, and then we can now start adding some forest on the background. So just blue and raw umber, a little bit of red, and then some white. Sorry, everyone. Like that. Can you use blue on the raw umber? There, okay. And then we can now use the bristle flat brush. This one, everyone. Use this one. This one is way smaller than the other one that we use. The 1.5 flat brush. So again, the same color, raw umber and the blue. We can use some pine trees. We can put some pine trees here. There. So just tapping technique, everyone. Just follow the strokes that I'm doing. Damn. Okay, so we have now some details on the top part. Yeah, we can see there that some trees on the background, some trees and some, yeah, maybe you can put some greenish or so that it can have a little bit of life there. So yellow and the blue. Okay. I'm gonna put some details here, some rocks on the bottom. Before, I'm gonna try to put the fish here, so the fish will be like that. Yeah, or maybe I will try now to put the fish. I'll try to draw because it's already dry. Yeah, I think this is a perfect time. I'll just draw and put some underpainting. So maybe I'll just use the light yellow, okay, like that, to draw the fish. And I'm gonna use a 0 liner brush. Yeah, the small liner brush or round brush. Okay, you can put more water so that it become wet and fluid. So the fish will be big. I don't know how I'm gonna form this one, everyone. Actually, I have no reference. Actually, that's just the form of the fish, but the problem is the reference is different. Actually, I have no study in the, I didn't study the whole scene, so I'm not really sure what kind of fish will come out this one. I don't know, very bad idea. I'm not really sure what kind of fish will come out. He is a little bit moving, going upward, everyone. So that's the plan that I'm gonna do to the fish. We're starting like that, moving a little bit. So like that, it's kind of hard, yeah, I think. And then I'll try to put something here, like a fin. The eyes will be in this part. I don't know, everyone, if I'm doing right. Here, it should be here. I don't know, even if this one is fine, or I don't know. I don't know if I hope that it's not bad. I have that.
Doesn't look bad.
Actually, I just drew it directly here. I didn't have any study on what it will look like. So hopefully I can give justice to this fish. Actually, it's a rainbow trout, everyone. I've never seen rainbow trout in my life. So it might look odd. Hopefully, I give justice to this one. So, wish me luck, everyone. Something like that. So yeah, that will be my the look of the fish, the anatomy. So yeah, I don't know, maybe I'll just try to focus first on the fish. Yeah, or the background. And maybe I'll just try to add a little bit of underpainting on the fish before I'm gonna try. Yeah, a little bit of underpainting. Before I'm gonna try to add more details, okay? I just wrote Umber. So that I will know which part I'm gonna paint the face. So blue and the red. I'm using the small flat brush, everyone. Okay, so adding some white to make the bottom a little bit gray. Yes. Like that. Okay. Yeah, something like that. Then you can put a little bit of a little fin here. And maybe here, something, everyone. At least we'll have idea. And here a little bit dark, yeah.
That's it. So I have now the idea, everyone. So what it will look like, I don't know, maybe the head a little bit bigger, so I have to retouch that later on. I'm going to cut a little bit here, so it's good to try and error also, because yeah, we will know what we're gonna do. Okay, so yeah, maybe I'm going to add first here the rocks, something like that. So I will be using the medium size flat brush here. Yeah, I'll try to use darker color. I have no black, everyone, so I'm gonna use this blue and the red or dark purple. Okay, so maybe I'll do something like this. I'm gonna add some white and yellow. There, then let's try to put some rocks here. A little bit of greenish. There. I'm gonna add some very bright color here for one. From the top part, so maybe I'm gonna use yellow and the white. A little bit of blue, yeah. There. I'll cut a little bit here. There, okay. The color's a little bit dirty. We can put a little bit of yellow green. So yellow and the blue. There. I just try to lighten everyone the back the surrounding colors of this fish so that I can have a better contrast. There. Yellow and the blue. We can put a little bit here. Something like that, just a horizontal white stroke, everyone. Just bring it good, everyone. Bring it good. I'm gonna make this part a little bit lighter. There. Okay. And also here, even in the bottom part, I want to make this very contrast. There. And then you can try this yellow and the blue to make some greens. There. And also on the other side, everyone, make it a little bit blue green. I'll just blend it a little bit here to make it more greenish. There. The other one also, let's put some colors also here, a little bit bluish. Or a little bit of blue-green, something like that. Okay. Then I'll try to mix for a little bit blue green, everyone. Just blue and the green, blue green. Just like that. Just create some kind of objects there or blendings, and even here I can try to put also. Okay. And then not just everyone, we can put also some colorful rocks on the bottom. Yeah, I think mostly some brown rocks there I need to put. So yellow and then red. And then draw umber. There. You can put something here, everyone. Look like that. It's far, something like that. That there's still object there. I'm gonna put some trees on the bottom here, everyone. Something like that. There are also trees in the bottom part, which is like the old tree, something like that, or the tree that fall in the river. Blue under umber, and we'll adjust this color one. There. Yeah, I can also put another put one here. There are a lot of roots, actually, everyone can find on the bottom. There. I'll try to make this part dark, but I need to put some raw umber. Raw umber and the blue. Just mix the raw umber and the blue, everyone, and you can make it look like dark. It's gonna look like dark. Okay. Can also put some darks here, everyone. Little bit darks. Okay. You can make it a little bit lighter, especially in the far part. I'll try to add one tree here. It should be a lot of trees, but I'm gonna use this one a little bit lighter. With some brown. There. Yeah, so we can see that there's a lot of things there, especially in the farther part, and it's very bright. The color is very bright. I like it. Everyone. You can also put some brown grasses. Okay, just umber. Let's try to put it here. And then let's start adding some light details on the. I'm gonna make it a little bit yellowish, everyone, on this tree here. I am using a small brush. I can use the tapping technique. There. You can also put greenish around to look like an algae, some algae on the body. Raw umber and then yellow. Okay, at least you can see different colors. And also here. I'm using the small brush, everyone. And then we can try some yellow greens. There. Put greenish, everyone. Put some greenish there to make it look like there's also greenish, okay? There's some moss or something like that, algaes. Okay, there you go. Slowly, everything becoming is unfolding. Okay, and then you can put some dark greens, yellow, and the blue. Or you can put some blue greens, everyone. And also here. There, as you can see, everyone, there's a lot of things there. You can see some trees in the bottom of the ocean. Bottom of the lake or a river. So yeah, this fish is some kind of big, huge fish. We can use this blue green one to add more here. I will remove our purples. Okay, there you go. Yeah, I think we can put more small rocks, everyone. Yeah, I want it brown. Mostly, as you can observe in the bottom of the lake, mostly they are brown rocks. So I'm gonna put a lot of rocks so that it will fill with colors. At the bottom. Okay, so as you can see, everyone, there's really a lot of things there. And it looking like flat, okay? It looks flat now. And it looks good. I like that. Okay. So I'm gonna put more tinier details using this small brush. Small brush again. The same brush, the flat brush. Raw umber and the blue. There. Okay, yeah, later on we can put more retouch. Okay, so I'm going to go back on the top, everyone, and then yeah, maybe I will try to retouch more. Yeah, I'll just try to retouch more there. I'll just try to add some more lights, maybe some greenish color, blue and the yellow and then white. Okay. Everyone, so yeah, I think that's fine. You can see now a very flat surface of the river, so I'm gonna try to put more. I think this one, umber, a bit of umber and then blue. And then white also. Okay. Can put some horizontal roots, everyone. Yeah, something like that. Climbing from the top. Then using this light brown here, can also put some color. There. To make it look more like there's a lot of fruits. Okay, let's try to add some lights there. Okay, we're using this brush, everyone, the number 2 Nylon flat brush. I have here the blue and the white to make it light blue. Okay, then let's put something like white there. There. Put something like that, everyone, to be details. No tap. Okay. A little bit disturbance here. And then we can mix for the blue and the red. But I'm going to put more blue, bit of white. Yeah, it should be dark, everyone. Maybe a little bit of umber. Okay. There. Okay. So there is in between, everyone. You can add a little bit of white. There. Okay. And you can use also white. Okay, so look like that there's space, okay, but there's space between the landscape on the top and also to the fish, okay? So I will not make it so much complicated. I'll try to retouch on the landscape on the top, everyone. So blue umber and the blue with a little bit of red or some yellow. Bit of white and then yellow. Okay. So blend it wood. Okay, there you go. So yeah, we can now see the horizon, okay, between the water and the land. Okay, so I will not make it so much I will just make it so like a simple and easy so that everyone also can paint. Okay, so let's put something, everyone. Let's put some details on the fish. Let's make it look like a real fish. So I'm gonna use this brush, this flat brush, and then I can use some red and then yellow. A bit of orange and can put it here. There. Then the other one here. And we can also put a little bit of red here. Damn. And then even on the tail, everyone. Okay. Let's try a little bit yellowish. Can put a white there. Okay. There. And then we can try a little bit of light green one, because this fish has a very beautiful color. More yellow. There. Okay. And then we can put also some silver. So I'll just use blue and the red. There. You can put a little bit of white or even some blue color. And then on the belly part, everyone can put there some orange. There. Or maybe you can put some raw umber, especially here. There, and even here everyone can just put some raw umber. There, and then we can try the raw umber and the yellow color. There, okay, cover it. And then this one also here. Slowly, everyone, we can build up the tones that we need to create this wonderful painting of a trout, okay? And then we can try this red and then white. Yeah. And then from light yellow, everyone, and white, we can add a little bit of lights on the top. Okay. Yeah. Here, everyone, the light green, we can move it a little bit. Yeah, okay. And then I'll just use this umber. I'll make this part darker. Like a fin, everyone. Can put a little bit of orange or reddish on this part on the cheek, everyone. It has a little bit of reddish and orange there. It looks good. Okay. Now I'm going to try to add the darker color in the mouth. Blue and the red. And then I'm gonna try to put eyes here. Okay, but I'll try to add a little bit of details, everyone, especially in the. I use this umber, especially on the bottom part here. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so the next one, I'm going to try to add details on the mouth. So I'll be using the reddish purple with more white. Okay, so we're gonna do the details slowly. Okay. Yeah. There you go. Also here. I think that's slowly becoming better, everyone. Looks like now. Trout, okay. I'm going to retouch the eyes. I just use this umber, everyone. Yeah, just make it dark. Then also here. Okay. So look like now a rainbow trout. I never seen a rainbow trout, everyone. We cannot find like that in the Philippines. There. And then I will try some brown, everyone. Red, yellow, and then umber. I will put a little bit brownish on the side of the mouth. Okay.
Gonna make it darker here.
And then let's put some
highlights on the eye. Then this also this one if you want. There, okay. I get I make a bit some a little bit exaggerated, okay. And then I'm gonna try this yellow and white. We will also put one more fin, everyone. I think I need to put more fin, okay, on the back. So I can see that there's also fin here. Okay, so there's also fin there, okay? Yeah. I think this is a very colorful rainbow trout. How far is this a rainbow trout? So it's colorful. And then we can start now putting some spots, everyone. I will just use the umber.
There. Okay, so yeah, I think that looks like now a rainbow trout, and it looks good, everyone. It looks very colorful. It doesn't look so much realistic, which is I like it. I like this one. It doesn't have to be really perfect realistic painting, just like that, and can give justice. Okay. Okay, so I'll just try to retouch. Okay, so white and a little bit of yellow. I will try to add a bit of a bit of details there, or highlights, something like that, that it look like shining. Okay, and even here, everyone, kind of like that. Look like a shining part, and then we can also put on the gills. Okay, and we can also put a little bit of light here. Okay, can put a little bit of yellow even here. There. And then we can put some bubbles. So I just have to use the white, everyone. Need a little bit of blue, not so much white. Thank you.
Okay, I'll just try to retouch everyone, and I think I am done. Okay, I will call it done. I'll just try to put some little bit objects on the front, and then I'm gonna say that it is finished. Okay, so yeah, I think the fish looks good. I'm gonna try to use some white. I'm gonna try to add some light there. Okay. So right now, I'm gonna try to put some white and white here. There, so it looks like a reflection. And then let's try to put some. So, raw umber and then yellow. And put some grasses here, okay? There. And then you can use some white. Okay. Okay, so I think I am done, everyone, and I am very happy with the result. I hope that you are also happy, and actually you can paint it. You can paint this one. You can do something like this. You can copy, and you can also add more fish, add more details. Actually, this is actually for me, it's incomplete, everyone. I have to put a lot of things there. Maybe some details on the top here, on the trees, or even more here, and I'm detaching this part, the fish, I don't know. The more I'm gonna put details there, the more it become better, okay?
Okay, everyone, so I wanna say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like and some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praise always belongs to the Lord.